Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from York Racecourse here on Wednesday. It is the 12th of May, 2021. Gonna look at the stakes races on the program from York, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for racecourses around the world, and join me Saturday for my Lock-Inch preview, and also Saturday for my Preakness preview from Pimlico. It's going to be a really interesting Pimlico Preakness this week. I can tell you that with all the news. But let's look at the stakes races. Races 3 and 4 from York. The third race is 240. It's the Group 2 Duke of York Clipper Logistics Stakes. It's a Group 2 event for Class 1 horses going for a purse of $137,000. Race for 3-year-olds and upwards. We have a field of 12 horses going 1,200 meters. Or the distance of ground is 6 furlongs on the York turf course. I'm going to take the 11 horse Lady in France as a top selection. We'll go 11-7-1 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 11-7-1 Tri-Cash Trifecta. Top selection, 11 horse Lady in France. 5-year-old mare by Showcasing. Daniel Thud hopes on this one for Carl Burke. The horse's most recent outing, Lady in France's most recent outing, was in France at Longchamp on the 4th of October. 5 furlongs in the Group 1 Prix de l'Alibi de Longchamp. And the horse ran a very good race at 39-1. Finished 4th by 1/4 lengths. Got down the very tough 5 there at Longchamp. Quickened up a little bit. You know, nothing bad about that run. Coming here facing the boys again off the bench, very speed favoring track. I think the horse could really run a good race. 2 back in the Group 3 Prix de Petit Couvert at Longchamp, 5 furlongs September 13th. He finished 3rd by 1/2 lengths and again got down the race course well. Wasn't as in good race as the race afterwards, but still ran a terrific race there. And then before that here at York on the 19th of August, 5 furlongs in a Class 2 Phillies handicap, winning by 1/2 length, the 12th one with a high weight of 138 pounds. This horse had a great tracking position, quickened up easily, and had a left in the tank there. An all around great race. Before that, the seasonal reappearance in illicit stakes at Doncaster, the 14th of June of 2019. The horse finished 6th by 6.5 lengths there and kind of hit the wall there, just couldn't quicken up. I think the horse needed the race there off the bench, but gained some serious class release from the last few races. Drawn on the stand side, which I like. 15-1, a very likely winner. Don't throw out the 7-horse Starman. Ocean Murphy's on this one. Not going to see the very soft ground like he saw at Ascot a few months ago, and I think on the quicker ground, back to a course and distance that he's won over, I think he could really run a good race. We'll use him here at 5-1, but to recap my selection of the 240, the third race from York, it is the Group 2 Duke of York Clipper Logistics Stakes. Let's take the 11-horse Lady in France, give kudos to the 7-horse Starman, 11-7-1 Tri-Cash Trifecta, 11-7 in the place pod. The fourth race, the 310, it is the Group 3 Misadora Stakes. It's Group 3 event for Class 1 horses going for a purse of $103,000. Race for 3-year-old fillies. 8 horses are going 2,000 meters or a mile and a quarter on the turf course. We're going to take the 4-horse Noon Stars top selection. We'll go 4-8-6 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 4-8-6 Tri-Cash Trifecta. Top selection of 4-horse Noon Star. This 3-year-old filly by Galileo, Judd Monon, Sir Michael Stout trains. Richard Kingsgoat gets the mount. The horse's most recent outing came the 25th of April. And Weatherby, a mile and a quarter in a Class 5 Phillies novice, and the horse went by 2.5 lengths there, and drawn on this a little bit towards an outside poster and a little bit of a high weight, but the horse settled well, quickened up nicely, and got the job done against very lesser quality horses. It was a very good race. Coming here to the mile and a quarter, second off the bench, very good post draw. I think the horse could stay the trip well, you know, off the pedigree, definitely going to get the mile and a quarter again. 2 back in Nottingham on the 3rd of 14th of October, 1 mile in a Class 5 Maidens Filly race. Stepping all the way down the class ladder was a good thing for this horse. Winning by 3.25 lengths. She sat back early, slowly moved her way up. When she got the turn of foot, she got the job done. An all-around good race. And then prior to that, 3rd September at Salisbury, 7 furlongs in the Class 3 Phillies maiden race. She finished 3rd by 5.75 lengths, which just drew on a little bit too wide, and it took a little bit of time to get going. I think she was a little lax days early on, and I think she needed the race since it was his first race as a 2-year-old, first third ever. But coming here, the 3-year-old campaign, second off the bench, should be a lot fresher since the Weatherby race. I'm going to take the horse here. The 8-horse Tiona is your second likeliest winner. Andrea Dezzini's on this one for Roger Varian, and the 2 races of the 2-year-old were very impressive. Even that place, you know, that was an impressive place there. And then after that, in the Newcastle over the mile and a quarter, winning by 9, just could have went around another 5 times and won that easily. Coming here, a very good pedigree to the 3-year-old campaign, drawn very well. Watch out for this horse. So to recap my selection for the 4th, the 310 from York, it is the future Group 3 Misadora Stakes. Let's take the 4-horse Noon Stars top selection. We'll give kudos to the 8-horse Tiona, 4-8-6 Tri-Cash Trifecta, 4-8 in the place pod. So good luck to all. Please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5. Good luck, everybody.